Hey, all right. Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's tip sent in by Joe Martin. Now, Joe is a frequent contributor to the podcast. He was watching one of the podcasts, and then as I created the pivot table, I just created the pivot table on a static range. And, I think that's what a lot of us do because we were creating pivot tables back since, five or six versions of Excel. So, data pivot table, and then in step two, we just leave it there as A1 through H564. Well, the problem with that is if we add more rows, then what do we have to do? We have to come back to the wizard and re-specify. And so Joe said, it'd be much easier just to specify a dynamic range. And we have a great new way to do this, starting in an Excel 2003 and newer. Now, in Excel 2003, what you're going to do is select one cell in your data and press ControlL. ControlL is going to define that range as a list. Now, in Excel 2007, they replace this with ControlT. Either way, same basic concept. So we'll create data, pivot table, finish, and let me just put region along the left hand side and revenue in the heart of the pivot table. So $6.7 million. Now, let's say that we get some more records from somewhere. I'm just going to copy a bunch of records, and we paste those immediately below our table. Notice down there in row 565, that little asterisk, kind of like in Access, the new record asterisk. That's saying, hey, anything you paste here is going to become part of the table. I do Control-V, and sure enough, that causes all of those new records to become part of the table, and any charts or pivot tables that refer to that table are going to work perfectly. So all we have to do, we don't have to re-specify the data range, simply click the exclamation point to refresh the data and it gets us the new data. Great way to do dynamic ranges in Excel 2003 and newer. Now before that, we would have had to define a name with the offset function, much, much harder to do, simply easier in 2003 to hit Control-L or in 2007, Control-T to convert your pivot table range to a dynamic list or table. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.